presence no one knows. Has the face, lies the smell. In our disgrace, more than keen, some mustache. Meet the black, the sky looks dead. Till more name through the cream. You scream again. Black hole sun, won't you come? Wash away the rain. Black hole sun, won't you come? Won't you come? Won't you come? Stirred away, colding down. Steal the warm winds I had from. Drums are gone for honest men. And sometimes thought too long into the snakes. In my shoes, a walking snake. In my youth, I pray to keep. Driven sins held away the old boy. Singing's like you. Black hole sun, why won't you come? Wash away the rain. Black hole sun, why won't you come? Why won't you come? Black hole sun, why won't you come? We wash away the rain. Black hole sun. Why won't you come? Why won't you come? Why won't you come? Tell you all just disappear. Black hole sun, why won't you come? We wash away the rain. Black hole sun, why won't you come? And why won't you tell us? Black hole sun, why won't you come? Wash away the rain. Black hole sun, no one's come. No one's come. Why did you come?
Hello, hello. Let's go. We got it. We got the closed beta. Let's go. All right. Well, I'm Preacher, and thank you so much for watching my stream and tuning in. I was chosen specifically for this closed beta 2 access for Wuthering Waves, this new gacha game that's coming out. And I want to go ahead and play it with you guys. So, let's go ahead and start this up. I'm going to also shrink my model. Let's see how that does. Yeah, I think that's good enough. All right, so if you're new here, my name is Preacher, and a little bit about me. I do professional sound production work, audio engineering. I am a radio board operator for a radio station, and I do a little bit of this, a little bit of that, but my main interest is in the theological world, the Christian studies of in-depth theological and philosophical questions. But my job is in audio production and production work. And let me turn this audio down a little bit. All right. Turn me up a little bit too. Guess I have to restart. Running multiple game instances to determine what? No, what? What is this? Let me hide your eyes for a moment while I figure this out. Let's see if that worked. I don't know what this says. I don't speak Chinese. I guess I have to hide your eyes once more. Just give me a moment. All right, I think I got it figured out. And let's go. I think I might adjust my model a little bit more here. Let's put me right there. All right. We choose the waifu, right? That's the only correct choice. Let's go! I'm super excited. Who are you? Who are you supposed to be? Oh no, don't touch me there. I did not give you permission to touch me in my no-no square. Oh no. Oh no, this is too lewd! Hand-holding! I'm a Christian! Oh? You really could just hold my hand and then drop me like yesterday's garbage? I expected a little bit of commitment. I mean, maybe not exactly marriage, but okay, this game is pretty beautiful. I'm not gonna lie. Move the cursor. I've been having these weird dreams lately. I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this real? Or is it all a dream?
Oh! Yeah!
Is there not voice acting? I think that might be because it's in beta. Miriam chatting up a storm. Are you all right? Do you feel any discomfort? You are? You could call me Chixia, and she's Yang Yang. Where am I? We are in the Gorges of Spirits. It's on the outskirts of Jingzhou Honglong. I don't speak moon. Your attire doesn't seem local. Are you a roving traveler from afar, or someone returning home? Rover? So you don't know why you're here, where you're from, or who you are. Bai-Zi didn't tell us you'd have these after effects when you wake up. The wind has brought us warning. The etheric sea is converging. It seems a new tacit field is taking shape.
What do you mean? Speak English!
That means it's probably going to get dangerous here soon. Ugh, I knew it. Our gourds are out of service because of the etheric sea's influence. We can't send or receive messages for help now. We better hurry over to meet up with Bai-Zi at our gathering spot and get out of... Guess you really can't recall a thing, but don't worry. If you got any questions, we can talk as we move. Yang Yang and I will give you the full scoop, every little detail, from the get-go. Rover, can we call you that before you can remember your true name? I can already see that this is definitely an ESL game. I'm having trouble reading, partially because my brain no worky, but another part of it is this isn't an actual coherent English structure. It's not exactly translated properly, I don't think. Basically, what she's asking is, can we call you Rover for now because you can't remember your actual name? Suits me. We shouldn't stay here. If you don't have other plans, how about leaving with us for now? Is there only one way out of the gorge? The terrain is complicated here, and we usually take that one route. If you don't mind, why don't we travel together for now? You can decide your future plans once we leave the gorge. Yeah, let's get going. Hold up. I just realized. I think my OBS is all screwed up. There, that should fix it. All right. I was not paying attention. Okay. We have resonators who can detect the formation of tacit fields nearby, like what Yang Yang just did. She can tell all kinds of information, something, I don't know. While I couldn't feel a thing, haha. Hold up. Let's give it the old testy doodle. So right click seems to make you dash around. Ooh, I'll take that. There's not a double jump, but you can make yourself go a little bit higher by attacking at the height of your jump, I suppose. Oh, there we go. Shift while in midair makes you jump another time. All right. Rover, I know you can't remember a thing, but there's one thing I'm 90%, no, 100% sure about you. You must be a resonator too. You must be a keyblade wielder. What? You got a tacit mark on the back of your hand, and you have a gourd. Plus, not many people hang out in the wilderness. I don't understand what I'm supposed to do. Oh, I'm supposed to climb this. Okay. Okay. So does that function as a dodge? Use resonance skill. Okay. All right. Forte accumulates with every hit landed. When Rover's Forte gauge is 50%, you can enhance your resonance skill. I suppose that's what the spinny blade is. V to navigate. Let me get that foie gras. Booty, 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 rocking everywhere. It's a dragon. Can you resurrect Goku, please? What's wrong? You're injured from the fight? What is this statue? This statue is of Jue, the sentinel of Jingzhou. There are one court and six cities in Jingzhou, with each city having its own sentinel. While they share some similarities in appearance, there are also differences. Are there other sentinels outside of this place? Sentinels are present where civilization and history thrive. Feng Long stands out with the highest number of currently coexisting sentinels because of its long history and vast land. Records state the sentinels in Honglong were once a single entity. Now, they are each responsible for a part of Honglong. Naturally, there are sentinels in other regions too, but far fewer compared to Honglong. What do the other sentinels look like? In Honglong, most of the sentinels take the shape of a long boy. In other regions, they manifest in various forms. Some are even beyond our imagination. I saw myself standing face to face with it. You're standing face to face with our sentinel? One can hardly see our sentinel with their own eyes. Most people only get the chance during the appointment ceremonies. According to your description, you stood pretty close. Normally, only the sentinel's appointed resonator is allowed in its proximity. Currently, that person is the magistrate of Jingzhou. Perhaps it's just my imagination. Whoa, darn. That must be an elite class. Jixi, I might be in danger. Rover, please! Okay. Okay. R to use resonance liberation. What was that? Two to switch to Yang Yang. I'm pressing two. Oh, I'm already switched. I expected some sort of sparkly stuff like every other game. Honkai Star Rail. Genshin. You know, every other game. Okay. All right. Oh, you can dodge. Okay. Switch to party members with glowing icons to release their powerful outro skill. I like the combat. It feels like, I don't know, fluid, and I like aerial combos and stuff like that. I feel like this game would be a lot better on controller. I wonder if it works with controller. I guess that'd be something to test, huh? Since I am testing this game, let me plug in my pad. It doesn't seem to work. Wonder if it's in the settings. Oh, that looks promising. Does not appear to be. Oh, wait, hold up. I see some. There we go. Manage voice packs. English in use. There's not even any voice, though. I haven't heard a single word. Maybe we try Japanese. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't seem that it has any settings for a gamepad. Wait, vibration? Vibration for what? Whoops. No. My freaking Steam. No. Get out of here. Okay. I mean, the game looks pretty good already. I don't think I have to change anything in terms of the graphics. It's just odd that it says it has a vibration setting and there's there seems to be no gamepad settings. All right. Let me try a different gamepad then. And actually, let me try closing out of Steam. Hold on. I'm gonna hide your eyes again. right, so I closed out of Steam. My other controller doesn't work either. Stopping to relax once in a while serves for a stronger resonance with the world. So there are voice lines, it's just not in the cutscenes, I guess, huh? Oh. Let me try something else. I'm gonna try exiting out of the game. I still have your eyes closed because my email address keeps popping up in this game. That's not exactly something I want out there. I will take the title card away as soon as I feel like my sensitive information isn't going to pop up all of a sudden. Nope. There is no pad support at the moment. Or at least that's how it seems. All right. I can open up your eyes, stream. Okay. Well, we can verify that it definitely keeps track of where you log out at. That's good to know. I wonder if that language pack that I downloaded, like, fixed whatever made it to where there weren't voice lines for the story. Okay. The notice works, but it's really slow. Actually, I don't think it does. Now that I mention it. Okay, there we go. Very slow. That's something to take note of. Perhaps I should take out my notepad and write this stuff down. Actually, I think I'll just pull out my boogie board. All right, down there. So No.
We'll go ahead and write down.
Hold on. Let me move back.
We'll go ahead and write down. No voice lines in story. Slow notice board. Almost cripplingly so. Oh, I guess it was just loading up. Might have been my. I'll cross that one out. Okay. Oh, hey, Dory. No, you're not allowed to spend money. You're not allowed to spend money in the closed beta. There is no topping up in the closed beta. It specifically said that in the email. So you don't have to worry about me spending money on this. Not that I have the money to spend anyways. Okay. I got a new sword. Let's take a look. Backpack, maybe? Or is it resonate? Yeah, resonators. No. Switch. Side booba. I like the black hair with the white under whatever that's called. I don't think those are called highlights, but my sister would probably slap me if she heard me say those things because I don't know what it's called. And she's a hairdresser. The different menus seem to work just fine. All right, we'll just move on. When you see a beacon. After activating a small residence beacon, you can open the map interface to choose the activated beacon to fast travel. All right. I feel like there should be voice lines. Let me actually try swapping over. The English voice lines are bigger in file size, so you'd think it'd be just fine. How do I use? It says English is in use. Maybe I have to actually. Yeah, okay.
No, it is a beautiful game. Once we're out of the gorge, there's a short walk to whatever. I couldn't read that fast. Jingzhou is the safest place around here. The Resonance Nexus provides coverage for the whole city. Besides, we've got a protective barrier and strong fortifications. Sounds impressive.
Right. Jingzhou sits right between the Desrock Highland and the Norfolk Barrens. It is a border city, as well as a fortress. Therefore, it is referred to as the Throne of Huang Long.
We've agreed to meet up with Baizi here. Where is she? Hello, Georgie. How are you tonight? We've discovered that it seems like there aren't actually any voice lines in the story for the closed beta. This might be a glitch, but I'm starting to just think that they did not actually voice the story for the closed beta. That's what I'm starting to think. It wasn't here when we just got there. But I didn't sense a hint of a tacit field's presence. So it appears, while we weren't looking, like in the blink of an eye? Or maybe the etheric sea can tell where we are. Could it be following us? The center of this tacit field. Someone is there. Isn't that Baizi? Baizi. Baizi! We are too far apart. Perhaps she can't hear us. Why is she there? We agreed to meet up around here, and she said she was off to collect some samples. Gosh, did she really go straight into the heart of the tacit field for that? Baizi wouldn't take such risks without careful consideration. Freshly formed tacit fields go through a dormant period. The faster tacit discord forms, the longer its dormant period. For now, this tacit field should be safe. Let's go down then. True. The glider can't carry us beyond the tacit field's range. Besides, Baizi is there. We'll have to go down and see what's going on. Now it's time to use the glider module. W to move off the cliff. Okay.
Baizi!
Baizi, we're in a dormant tacit field, right? Why did you come here by yourself? Baizi, you know we... Huh? Hello. You know, she was super energetic, handled a super big TD with ease, way more spirited than me. I've been keeping an eye on her condition. I couldn't read that fast. Amazing. What's going on? Is this a mind-reading gathering? It isn't. Baizi is just concerned about your condition. She must think we shouldn't be letting you move around that much since you just regained consciousness. This isn't the place for talking. I couldn't read the rest of that. Okay. Boss time already, huh? Defeat ? Tap to lock the camera angle. Oh, okay. Wait, I would have liked to push H there. So you're able to lock on like Dark Souls or Kingdom Hearts. This really is Kingdom Hearts. Kingdom Hearts is light. All right. Okay. All right. That looks pretty cool. All right. All right. Okay. That was pretty neat. All right. All right. The combat is pretty sick. I mean, this is the same developer as Punishing Gray Raven, so it shouldn't be a surprise, but yeah. Yeah, this is some good combat. Okay. Keep getting hit by that ground slam. I'm out of stamina, that's why. Counterattack. All right, that's pretty cool. Yeah, let's view that. When the enemy uses a specific move, a flaw circle will appear. At this time, if you hit the enemy, you can make a counterattack, which can not only interrupt the enemy's attack, but also gain unexpected effects. Music's really good. Finishing attack, huh? Mobilize. Oh, mobilize. I'm not sure if that's actually how it's... Like, they could just be like, oh, we're quirky. We're spelling it O mobilize. It's our patent-pending O mobilize. But I'm pretty sure that they just meant to put immobilize there. And they spelled it wrong. ESL. I'm going to write that down. The immobilize tutorial window. As spelling error. All right. Let's actually read it. Dealing damage can reduce the enemy's vibration strength, and counterattack can greatly reduce the enemy's resonance degree. When the vibration strength is cleared, the enemy enters the immobilized state. After being immobilized, the enemy cannot act for a period of time. Yeah, this game is sick. Okay, this game is actually really sick. Yang Yang Rover! Are you all right? Are you hurt? I'm fine. Oh, thank goodness. We could see that darn barrier, but couldn't lay a finger on it. I'm fine, too. I have never seen such a formidable tacit discord before, but Rover was able to completely defeat it. Piece of cake! Rover, what was that last move called? That looked as cool as Fiamma's killer move. That's strange. This place isn't known to be so dangerous. Anyway, come check this out. An illusion left by the tacit discord. Oh, this is an echo? Wow, an echo of the elite class. Someone got lucky today. My apologies, we got a little carried away. Does reverberation or echo ring a bell to you, Rover? Everything in our world is made up of frequencies, and every sound generates a reverberation. Those echoes are lingering reverberations of tacit discords after they disintegrate. We can absorb them into the databanks in our Pengu terminals. Oh, by Pengu terminal, she means the gourd-shaped device every resonator has, developed by researchers in Honglong. But you see, it's not always we get to find these. Also, there's a limit to what your gourd can absorb. Absorption is only possible when your databank's level is equal to or higher than the tacit discord's level. The terminal can then convert its reverberation into an echo for use in battle. My terminal issued a warning when it detected that tacit discord earlier. It should at least be an overlord class. Rover, would you mind checking your databank level? No need for that. Rover, why don't you just try absorbing it with your terminal? He's a phantom. It says I'm level 0. No worries, you can start with smaller ones before tackling this guy here. There should be some sweet baby rose shrooms around here. Not sure what those are, but okay. We'll need to report the unusual phenomenon here. Let's make our exit. I'm gonna write that down, actually. Auto dialogue too fast. Too fast. Whoa, what's happening? What kind of power is that? Rover, you've been playing the fool all along. I've never seen a resonance ability quite like this. You got any other tricks up your sleeve? Like eating a whole tacit discord? Grilling echoes alive? How does that relate to my cooking skills? I heard some folks tried to cook gold puffs, but they even made it a local specialty, didn't they? Speaking of which, gold puffs, a type of tacit discord. I'm even more curious now. Anyway, spicy food is always the best. Based and red-pilled. Rover, are you feeling all right? Any discomfort? Could it be the side effect of fighting that tacit discord? Baizi, can we take Rover to do a checkup at Huazhu Academy's Resonance Medical Department? Yeah, I need a checkup. Baizi. Absorbing echoes with the human body is not entirely unprecedented. With the human body? I remember Comprehensive Mirror for Historians mentioned this in the Huanglong section's opening. A celestial being descended, commanding the Qing Kun's, I guess that means universe, universe's boundless power, assuming mortal form, they condensed the primordial essence, creating Pengu, cleaving heaven and earth apart. They aligned the what? What did they align? Maybe I should write that down too, but I don't know how I would even write that down. Celestial beings descended. Dialogue cut off. Suppose when I send in my notes on the beta, I can also just give them the timestamp to this stream. That sounds mysterious. That's where the names Pengu Terminal and Qing Kun Databank come from. Whether it's true or not, that story happened a long time ago when Jingzhe didn't even exist. Could it be that Rover's like the great-great-great-great-great-granny of us all? Let's not jump to conclusions without enough data and proper analysis. Call me Rover for now. I don't think that that's what they meant to translate there. I'm just gonna have to like verbally make a note and then check the VOD when I go ahead and send in my notes for the beta. Cause I'm starting to run out of boogie board space. Wait, the signal's back. Is this a holographic message of all the Jingzhou from the city hall? Or to all the Jingzhou from the city hall? My fellow soldiers and citizens, I apologize for any inconvenience caused. I am Jingxi, the magistrate of Jingzhou. Yeah, she's cute. I would like to roll for her. As the moon-chasing festival approaches, the city welcomes visitors from around the world. The festivities are highly anticipated by our people, and I, too, share in this joyful sentiment. Jingzhou has always been a crucial defense against tacit discord outbreaks, safeguarding Huanglong. We have a heavy responsibility on our shoulders with no room for retreat or failure. It is the dedication of our warriors, along with the diligence of our citizens, that has allowed us to thrive in peace and prosperity. Despite the challenges of tacit discords, we remain steadfast and hospitable to visitors, upholding our enduring traditions. With that in mind, I have a favor to ask. Among our many visitors, there is one visitor that holds utmost importance to me. The city of Jingzhou and the entirety of Huing Long. We have awaited your arrival for a long time. Given the circumstances, you may be feeling bewildered at this time. You should have noticed some strange happenings related to you. If you plan to stay in Jingzhou for some time, I would be more than delighted to personally meet you in the city hall of Jingzhou. While I cannot guarantee to provide all the answers you need, I will do my best to assist you and provide necessary permissions if applicable. This is only my personal request. You can decide your course of action in any way you see fit. Therefore, I request the people and soldiers of Jingzhou to assist this esteemed visitor when the opportunity arises. Why do I get this feeling that this person our magistrate was talking about is Rover? Moon Chasing Festival? The Moon Chasing Festival and the Spring Long Festival are the liveliest times in Huing Long. They are two of our most famous traditional festivals. Every region in Huing Long will be celebrating the festivals in their unique ways. Jingzhou is a city built on the borders, but it's no exception in that regard. Hey, that ain't... I didn't read all of that. What are your plans now, Rover? Take a look at those festivals. There's still a while before the festival break. I couldn't read the rest of that. If you're eagerly anticipating the festival atmosphere, I'm afraid you will end up disappointed. But if you can stay in Jingzhou for a little while longer until the moon chasing festival activities begin... Hold on, what is... It's already automatically playing the dialogue, even though I don't have it on auto mode, which... I don't understand why that is. All right. I remember you had a flashback of yourself looking into its eyes when you saw the statue of our sentinel. We can't confirm its authenticity, but based on the magistrate's message, it seems Jingzhou has a lot to do with your past. Whether you're the visitor our magistrate mentioned or not, you are surely important to Jingzhou, and you will be our important friend. We've already entrusted our lives to each other. I've never seen so many TDs packed together, and that elite one was so scary. Well, you did get rid of most of them. Anyway, once we're back in Jingzhou, I'll treat you to that famous specialty from Penhua's restaurant. Let's head to the city. All right. Let me do a thingy here. Now that I've properly seen how this game's interface is, I'm just going to go ahead and move my VTuber model. Over to this side. And I can even enhance. Why is a... Hold up. Let's do it from OBS, actually. Yeah. Like that. And, cut. Oh, made it worse. How about right there? Cut. Yeah. Okay. Dang it. Why is it doing this? There we go. Let's zoom in and enhance. Yeah. Maybe right there. Yeah. Okay. All right. Now we can get back to it. Hold on, actually. Let me check the stream status. Okay, I'm ready. Yeah, this combat is really good. Oh, I can give it the old suck. Can you reenact what you did before? I feel nothing. Maybe you can only absorb the powerful ones with your body. Or does it have to be a certain type of tacit discord? Or maybe we should give your terminal a whirl. He's a phantom. Gotta catch him all. His name is Danny Phantom. Okay. So this is how you get gear, I guess. Equip this echo for its echo skill and extra attributes. So this is like, equipment and artifacts in Honkai Star Rail, I guess. And probably a close equivalent. Resonators can use the echo skill of the echo equipped at the top. Summon a detonation to cause spectro damage and create a stagnation area. Okay, is it going to go away? Hello? I guess not. Well, that was annoying. What's this? Oh, okay. Okay. That's cool. So can you do that with every enemy that you fight? Q to use. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty cool. When tacit discord is defeated, the remaining frequency may become an echo. Echo is an important source of combat power for the resonator. If it is equipped in the first place, it can also release its echo skill. The first absorbed echo can accumulate data bank experience. The upgrade of the data bank can increase the probability of echo appearing and gain higher stamina. The level of ESL in this game. This is my verbal note. Right here, timestamp right here. All right. Go to different areas of the world and discover more echoes. Oh, absorb. A whiff waff. Whiff waff. Street rat. I don't buy that. Okay. Oh, that is an enemy. And it's a level 6 enemy. So the dialogue seems to only affect the, like, in-battle dialogue. In-character. It doesn't affect the story dialogue. I'm going to switch it back to English. Okay. Activate this little beacon. Can we eat this goat? Yeah! Raw meat! Let's go! What's this? Get the thing. Get the thing. Can I get that? Hello? Let me grab that. Oh, it's like in Genshin when it takes you, the little wisp thing takes you to the chests. Okay. That's cool. Okay. Let's throw this bad boy out. And then do one of these bad boys. Bada beam bop pow. And then. Okay. I think we maybe should look around a little bit before we just head straight to the area where it tells us to go on the waypoint. I feel like I'm getting bad frame rate, but I can't tell. I wonder if there's a frame rate counter. Nah. No, it doesn't seem like there is. That's just the controls. Oh. There's no frame rate counter. I don't want to have to use like an overlay, like my NZXT overlay either, so. Whatever. What's this? What's going on here, boys? Oh, okay. Oh, there was a counterattack circle on that guy. Oh. Mm. Very nice. I like the combat. Gotta absorb the ghost. I'm going ghost! Fusion. Title heritage. Okay. Okay, what about the gacha system? Is there one of those in there? Or do I have to play a little bit more before I unlock it? I'm guessing I have to play a little bit more. Let me move my chat window up a little bit so that I can see it right in the corner of my eye. All right, we're good. All right, so there seems to be some sort of item over there too. Let's check this area out a little bit further. And then we'll go back to the waypoint. It might actually be worthwhile limit testing too. See how far I could go out of bounds in the map, that kind of thing. But we'll do that at some other point. I actually don't know how much time I have with this closed beta test. I didn't think to check. Okay. Sound emitter. Hold on. Defeat the surrounding tacit discord to ensure the successful start of the sound emulator. And you can complete the challenge and receive rewards. The music is so good. Huh? Okay, that's not where I meant for that to go. That was pretty lame. Hey, I did it. Not too hard. That's a little bit of my concern for this game, is that with as many tools as they give you to defeat your enemy, I can't see this game being very hard unless they really implement some like choreographed fights. Like raid level MMORPG choreographed fights. I don't know. Like, it feels like I'm way too strong. You know, I have too many tools at my disposal to get rid of the enemy. And, like, I've been in how many? Like, 4 or 5 fights outside of what the main story had me fight. And my health is still pretty decently high. Let's check the other character. Yeah, I've only lost about 100 health, so I can't see this game being very difficult. That might be something else I write in my closed beta test notes. Wonder what I have to do to get this bad boy. Oh, I have to lead one of those wispy things. Oh, over there. Hello? 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 Okay, there we go. That didn't unlock the chest. Oh, there's another one. Hmm. Aha! You have a lot more movement tools as well in this game. As opposed to like Genshin. Something like Genshin. Okay, there's one more. Aha! Okay. Easy enough. And it actually feels fluid too when you're like running up a cliff or going through like these rocky little boulder clefts. Like that. See? It actually looks natural. Looks like you're almost animated cutscene level, like natural, you know, choreographed. That one felt a little bit jank, but. It's a very good looking game. I will give it that. Very, very good looking. Very pretty. I mean, just look at this. All right? Is there a hotkey to like remove the HUD? Hold up. No. Oh, camera mode right here. And then, hello? It won't let me switch back. Why won't it let me switch back? Oh, okay. There we go. Where does it save that at? Zoom out. Yeah, there we go. Beautiful. I wonder if that does save it locally or if it's in the game. Data bank, maybe? Ooh. Currency. We take those. No, I think it has to be saved locally, and there's not any other area this could be in. Oh. I don't know what those are, but... provides one standard banner convene after use. Okay. All right. Here's the deal. Anyone who's in chat, I really have to use the bathroom, so I'm going to go ahead and take a quick break. I'll leave a song playing for you guys while I'm gone. And it should only be about 5 minutes. I'll be right back. How's that sound? BRB. Oh, what? Accidentally hit cut. BRB. All right. I'm back. All right. I was able to pour myself out some root beer. Good old A&W. We got the gamer fuel. We're ready. Okay. I did absorb some more Danny Phantom ghosts, didn't I? Oh, I can level up, huh? Max is level 20. Okay. Let's do the same thing for her then. Oh, I can't. I don't have all of what I need. What about the Danny Phantom ghosts, though? I do have more. I feel like since this guy is like a big dude, that he's probably like the one I should have in the first slot. Didn't it say that it's the first slot that gives you the ability? Yeah, yeah. I think that's what this little line here denotes. So I'm going to try this wolf boy. Equip. And then... Equip that guy. Equip that guy. What's this? Ah. Okay. I think we're ready. Oh, wait. Hold up. Trophies. More currency. We eat that. One of these I didn't actually read because it came up and left too quickly. Maybe I did. Oh, Resonator accumulates their current concerto energy when dealing damage or performing extreme evasion in combat. Switch the Resonator when the concerto energy is full. The exiting Resonator will trigger its outro skill and clear its own concerto energy. The entering Resonator will trigger its own intro skill. Okay. So basically, it's kind of like a tag team, like Tekken Tag Tournament 2. All right, I got it. Can we do infinites like in Tekken Tag Tournament 2? That'd be sick. Yeah, it feels good. It feels good. Even like jumping onto a ledge like this, it doesn't stop you. It just continues your movement like unimpeded. That's very nice. All right. I said we would go back and do the main story stuff, so I'm going to the waypoint. Ah, a beautiful day. The sun is shining. The wind is blowing. The Danny Phantom ghosts are gathering. Oh, this combat is so good. Oh. So fun. You know, I was watching Asmongold talk about this game, and he was basically saying, like, they don't expect anything special. It's not going to be that great of a game. It's not going to be better than blah, 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 blah. you know, kind of black-pilled up. No, this is pretty unique. This is pretty special. I played Tower of Fantasy, by the way, and I liked Tower of Fantasy. I liked its combat, but it was nowhere as fluid and intricate as this combat system is. Like, not even close. There's no question. Okay, so that was the wolf boy. That did a lot of damage. I need to move the chat box again. I don't know why it moved back over there. All right, we're good. Might as well pick up some stuff while we're on our way, right? What's this? Pressure. Pushing down on me. Pushing down on me. No man ask for. The pressure platform needs to be activated by placing objects on it. Near the pressure platform, there are load blocks that can be placed. Perhaps in addition to weight blocks, other things can be placed on the pressure platform. But it's locked. The block is locked. Oh. Oh, okay. Do I have to get one of those little wispy boys over here or something? I don't immediately see where it is. I think it might be up there, though. Like, there's a lot of those little pedestals. Isn't this one? Yeah, that's a little wispy boy pedestal. But what are these things? That's my question. Crane feathers. Those are enemies. Yeah. Ooh. I don't have a Hortoise. 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 I actually really like the whole capture the spirit of the enemies that you defeat and use them to like increase your battle power. That's pretty cool. That's pretty unique. I've not seen that in any of the weird Breath of the Wild knockoffs like Genshin and Tower of Fantasy. Not even in like Honkai Star Rail. Basically, they all use the same formula of like you go do raids, basically, that, you know, little dungeon things that are challenges, simulated universe and that kind of thing, and you get your items to equip to your characters, but getting them from the enemies you defeat, that's pretty neat. That's pretty unique. I've not ever seen that. Yeah. It does use stamina when you climb up like that, though. Oh! You have to be at a bit of an incline to climb up this way. Or, I suppose, if you find little clefts, you can do it that way. Oh! Two. What's this? The product of the collapse of the Sonero Sphere, scattered in various corners of the world, records the past that has not been lost. If you are lucky enough to find one of them, the relic merchants will be happy to exchange good things with you. Okay. That's not what I was looking for, though. I was looking for a way to unlock this thingy-majigger. Maybe I have to hit Yeah, okay. Yeah. Is there another one? Yeah. Do I have to hit it in a specific... Oh, no. There we go. How do I pick this up? How do I pick it up? It's not prompting me to pick it up. What am I supposed to do? Is it just bugged? Maybe you have to hit it with one of these. No. Hmm. I guess I'll write that down. Where's my pen? What is this called? Where's the tutorial? Pressure platform and weight block. No clear method of picking up weight block. Okay. Matt, you really want me to join the call? I suppose I can. All right. Anyone who isn't a direct acquaintance of mine that's watching this, I have a Discord that I frequent. A Discord server. Actually, nope, I'm not doing that. That's a trap. That is a trap. Halo is in the voice call right now. And he's playing Escape from Tarkov. I refuse. You're trying to get me banned. Halo straight up says the hard R. All the time. I do not want to get banned. So that's not happening while I'm streaming. Thank you, but no thank you. No, it's that's a trap. You're trying to trap me, dude. I refuse. I refuse to join the Discord voice call while I'm streaming with Halo in there while he's playing a game that is very infuriating or can be very infuriating. That sounds like a recipe to get my account banned. No thanks. But nice try, though, Matt. You almost got me. You almost got me with that one. Defeat the enemies within 180 seconds. What? Oh, I screwed up. I actually worked pretty hard to get the 1,000 subscribers or so that I have right now. I don't want to lose this account if I can help it. Okay.
But you almost got me. You almost got me, son of a gun. You little cheeky breeky boy. You almost got me with that one. You tried to pull a federal agent on me.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Here's the anarchist cookbook. Smiley face. Be a real weird shame if you used it to build a bomb or something.
All right. Almost got me.
I don't believe him. He says that all the time. I do not believe that he'll be a good boy, as you say. I'm not taking that chance. It's not happening. There is no universe where I am streaming on my YouTube account that I join a Discord server with Halo while he's playing a game that will spontaneously force him to use expletives that are banned in the TOS of YouTube.
Like, I get it. Sometimes you just can't help it.
Yeah, I know it's extremely valid. That's why I said it.
If it was just him sitting in there and, like, he just wasn't doing anything but, like, shooting the crud with you, I wouldn't mind, you know, joining. I think he can behave himself. Normally, but when he's playing a game like that, there's no way.
That Escape from Tarkov or Tekken, you know, either one of those things, I will not be streaming anywhere near Halo while he's playing either one of those games.
Rover? Garge. Chapter 1, Act 1.
Oh, who's that?
Is it a redhead? I like redheads.
Huh?
Oh, it's not. But she does look cute. She also looks funny.
All right, what should we do next?
Shall we go grab a bite?
Sounds good.
I am to return to the academy. The anomalies at the Gorges of Spirits. Or Gorges. It's late. All right. The Gorges of Spirits. The resurgence of the Tacit Field and the many waveform phenomenon occurrences. I should report them in time.
Oh, yeah, you got a seat of fate, Matt.
That's crazy.
Sounds like a lot of work.
It may take some time, but there won't be too much paperwork. Then I guess I'll take Rover over to the Nexus Tower for registration first, and we'll just hang out for a while. Being new to Jinzhou and all, she can't be left standing outside the city hall with nothing to do. Hospitality is our local specialty, you know. Then I'll leave you in Chixia's care, Rover. Is that all right with you? I'll give you a call once the paperwork is done. I need to take a sip of my root beer. My mouth's dry.
Drinking this root beer just makes me want a root beer float, but I don't have ice cream. I'm suffering now. Leave it to me. I'll send the branch of... What? Resin Medical Science a note. We need to conduct a... throughout physical examination. I think that meant to say thorough. I don't know about you guys. Verbal timestamp right here. Yeah, I'm going to move back and forth with my VTuber model so that I can see it physically. Yeah. Verbal timestamp right here. Typo. Come visit the academy after your audience if you have no other plans. A throughout examination. Oh, that'd be a shame. Yes, a physical examination would be required to determine if any disease is present. If no medical issues are found, we'll conduct further monitoring and analysis to understand what happened to your body. Of course, we won't do anything without your consent. Would be a shame if that happened. Would be a real shame. Let me move my microphone. Ah. All right. We're good. Maybe move it back a little bit down. Right. There. Okay. You guys done yet? What's the holdup? Let's move. Then I'll have more time to show Rover around. We've got loads of fun in Jinzhou. We can go watch lion dances, hero plays, stand-up shows, and then maybe the martial championships. I was going to say competition. Plus tons of various treats to try out. You think it? We have it. Yang Yang, Baiji, see you later. New resonator joined. Yes! The redhead! We got her for free. Let's go! One of my people. I do feel like the frame rate's really bad, but also there's motion blur. Can you turn off the motion blur? That's a good question. We don't need ultra quality shadows, that's for sure. Motion blur off. Thank you. Turn up the sharpening a little bit, I guess. Ah, oh, beautiful. I don't even know why they include motion blur as a thing. Who would ever want that? Makes me want to hurl. The frame rate still feels like garbage. I don't know what super resolution is, but I'll turn that off and I'll turn the sharpening back out down and maybe is there a full screen or oh no. You're not full screen windowed. Maybe turn off frame insertion. Yeah, that feels better. Here we are, Jinjo's Nexus Tower. Nexus Tower? Exactly. Let me see. Think of it as Jinjo's largest server station or an integration hub. It's something along those lines. I'm not much of a tech person myself. Long story short, it's a navigator, a defense system, and a regional information center all in one enormous package. Enormous packages, fellas. The smaller ones we ran into earlier are resonance beacons. Data is shared between all beacons. You activate one, and the entire map's data will be relayed to your terminal. Pretty nifty, huh? Just place your terminal here. The Resonance Nexus stores the information of the surrounding area, and you can obtain the corresponding map data after activation. Injured or fallen resonators can rest at the Resonance Nexus to recover.
I'm cultivating! Ugh.
So is this entire map available for the closed beta? That's what I'm wondering. I'm pretty sure it is. It wouldn't make sense otherwise. Seems pretty big already. I mean, it's not like gigantic, but for a closed beta. I have the arrangements in place. Rover, you can come visit the magistrate at any time. Chixia. Do you mind bringing Rover over to the city hall? Why can't I move my... Okay, there we go. Hold up. There's a few things on my mini-map I just noticed. I think I'm above something here. Ah, it is a store. I would like to purchase items. I don't know what any of those things do. But I'll remember that there is an item vendor. If in the event I am missing an item, there might be one at that vendor. What about these blocks on the map? Aha! They're chests. Hold up. Parkour over the dogs. I'm gonna do that again. Ended up accidentally swallowing some spit, or inhaling some spit, I should say. What are you doing? You look like you're interested in our training. I'm training a footwork technique to lion dance, the backflip. Oh, I forgot to introduce myself. I'm Julia, a lion dancer at Lion Dance Troupe. I'm a peer of the Ling Yang. The backflip? Lion dance is a dance style derived from martial arts. The postures and footworks often take root in traditional Hoang Long martial arts, in which the backflip is an essential move. Most of the time, we practice it on plum blossom poles at Central Plains. While I was in Jingzhou and the space was limited, I set up a temporary platform for practice. It attracted a great number of audience to my... And it didn't say anything else after that. Okay. It has gradually become a major street recreation here, so I decided to open it to the public. Everyone can try to do the backflip, and I hope this boosts the popularity of the lion dance. So, right before this, there is a piece of dialogue that was completely just missing. So this right here, another verbal timestamp so that I can come back, move my model around. In fact, I'll even do one of these, make it easier on myself. Okay. How should I do the backflip? Sorry, excuse me. I'm still choking and coughing. All right, I think I'm good. Me, my, me, more, more. All right. This one's for Dory. You gotta do the Mongolian throat singing. All right. Imagine the platform before you is a plum blossom pole, and underneath it is a rushing, freezing stream. Another lion confronts you, attempting to take your territory. Now you have to drive it away, yet the space doesn't allow you to perform martial arts, so you have to depend on the footwork. After all, you don't want to. All right, another verbal timestamp here so I can reference. Get my model window back out. Whoopsie. I didn't mean to do that. But that's good enough. All right. What was that explanation, by the way? I'm not just going to let that slide. I asked how to do the backflip, and he gave me a long dissertation about how I need to imagine a stream underneath me and then a lion attacking me, but I don't have room to do martial arts. What? How was that an answer? Excuse me? Care to reiterate that and maybe actually explain it? To win my challenge, you have to successfully perform a number of backflips in a limited time. No soaking, no help from other item. What? What is soaking? I didn't know he was a fan of water sports. You want to give it a try? Newbie in town, easy level. Perfect for beginners. Great introductory practice for every lion dancer. Get some warm up and we'll start right away. Left shift in the air to trigger a backflip. Only a minor slip. Do you want to try? Oh, I can't fall off the thingy. Oh, I think I accidentally pressed back. Okay. Oh, how am I not supposed to get soaked? I didn't even press back that time. Maybe if I press forward. I don't know what it wants me to do here. Okay. Thank you. Maybe if I go all the way. Yeah. Uh-oh. One more time. How many of these do I need to do? I suppose that is the only way to not fall off, huh? Oops. Oh. I got my command inputs flubbed up. What did I get? This? It seemed like a giant waste of time, to be honest. Wait, hold up. I didn't even pick these items up. I just walked past them. All right. So let's just go to the waypoint. I fell down that overpass, so I have to go back this way. There's a treasure chest underneath me, isn't there? Ugh. I don't care. I'll come back for it. Woo! Timmy's birds? Got a little bit of fowl meat. Hello, waifu. Woo! First time seeing such a crowd in front of the city hall. I was surprised, too. I've never seen so many non-staff personnel here before. Are they all here for an audience with the magistrate? Most of the people here have applied for an audience, but I heard they've all been turned down. Turned down by who? Most people were advised to leave by the magistrate's bodyguard upon sending in their applications. The ones staying here are either trying to apply for some other people or just too stubborn to leave. The few that made it inside said it only took one freezing look from Lady Sanhua and they were compelled to leave. What kind of description is that? Sounds like they've met some snake-haired lady. And got turned into stone. Who's Sanhua? She is the magistrate's personal bodyguard. Oh, I've heard of her before. She's the all-around death glare slash Terminator ice beauty. I'm sorry. What? What is this? What kind of... kind of title is this? And I can't tell if this is just because it's a translation error or that's what they meant to say, but that's not a sentence. Whatever, that's what the rumors say at least.
I don't want to hear. Well, maybe I should. There is a small chance she's not in the city hall, but it is very unlikely for her not to be in Jingzhou. Rather, it's nearly impossible for the magistrate to leave Jingzhou at all. With her busy schedule, it's already difficult to find any time off. In addition, as the magistrate of Jingzhou, leaving the land under her jurisdiction without authentication is not allowed. Unless she's engaged on a business trip or when Jingzhou's safety is under threat. Yep, there's gotta be something big if that's the case. Alright. So, this is true confidence of our rover. I agree, though. So far, you've been ticking all the boxes in our magistrate's description. Can holographic messages be pre-recorded? Sure they can. Have you thought of something, Rover? Perhaps the magistrate did not know who her guest was. She didn't do so just because her guest might be confused. What? I can't really keep up with your thoughts, but I think a meeting with the magistrate wouldn't hurt. Same here. Anyway, the magistrate's the best lead we have for now, no matter what she has in store for the rover. What do you think? Huh? Me? I'm just wondering how to take you, Yang Yang, and Bai Zi for some chow after this. But my shift's almost coming up. Don't know if we'll make it. I don't have anything in particular in mind. It was me who, I mean, we took you to Jingzhou. I think we should keep you company at least while you're here. Oh, I see. What do you think, Rover? Are you in a hurry to recover your memories? The loss of memory doesn't really bother me. In that case, how about meeting with the magistrate first? She may have the answers you're looking for. Isn't that the opposite of what I just said? Whatever. We are not allowed to go with you. Chixia and I will be right outside the city hall. We'll be waiting for you. That's right. We're not going anywhere. Just give us a shout if anything goes down. Wait, no. We won't be able to hear you. Plus, they've got this rule about not yelling inside the city hall. I still feel like I have something stuck in my throat. Give me a second. I've said this once before, this game is very beautiful. I think I'm good now. Please follow me. Oh, we do the catwalk. Yeah, the catwalk. Do a little turn on the catwalk. I just thought there was a little bit of dust on her backside there. Just checking to make sure there wasn't anything stuck there. Might have been a glitch or something. Mamma mia, who is this? Oh? Mangekyo Sharingan? Am I under the influence of Tsukuyomi? Pleased to make your acquaintance.
I apologize for the delay. My name is San Hua, the bodyguard of Madam Magistrate. Call me Rover for now. I regret to inform you that Madam Magistrate is currently away. Prior to her departure, she instructed me to bring you these tokens as a welcome gift. I don't know what that was. Madam Magistrate advised you to explore what these tokens represent during her absence. This may help you acquire the information you desire sooner. I apologize for the inconvenience, but please rest assured. She will be here to meet you in 3 days' time. Why 3 days? Because she will require at least 3 days to complete her current task. Madam Magistrate wanted to assure you that in 3 days, by any means, she will return to meet you in person. Is there anything I can do to help? You. I'll be sure to convey your kindness to Madam Magistrate. Please accept my sincerest gratitude. Yes, Madam Magistrate does hope to have your assistance, but there is no rush for a decision. She does not want to pressure you into anything you may not desire. We invite you to learn about our situation before making. All right, here's the thing. Here's the thing, chat. This has happened a few times now, where the dialogue seems to have gotten cut off, and I bet you anything that when I click to go to the next part of the dialogue, it won't finish what was cut off here. Let's see. Okay, so let me pull up my VTuber model again to give myself a little visual timestamp in the VOD. Once again, jiggle is back and forth. Okay. Now I will be able to reference this in a timestamp for the notes for the closed beta so that they know there's missing dialogue. Got it. How are you certain I was the guest? Since Madam Magistrate is currently away, I cannot make the final confirmation on her behalf. But you are truly exceptional. I heard many people were politely asked to leave. Regarding that, my eyes can see the frequencies of all living beings. Or rather, those frequencies are the only thing I can see. You share the same frequency with Madam Magistrate. What does my frequency look like? You look undistorted and authentic in your original form. In my eyes, you appear the way you are. What do the frequencies of others look like? They all look different. For some reason, you can tell San Hua doesn't want to continue this topic. May I have your terminal for a moment? Are we exchanging contacts now? Indeed. It was an oversight on my end. I will now import my contact information and that of all public services, like patrol stations, into your terminal. I will be here on standby, ready to assist whenever you need me. I need your terminal for regional access authorization. I will also configure the latest utility module for you. Madam Magistrate thought you might need it. Hand over the terminal. The utility module on your terminal has been upgraded to the latest iteration. Now all the utilities, including sensor, levitator, and grapple, should be fully functional. Okay! So, it turns out that the puzzle where I had to pick up the box, I'm guessing, right? I couldn't do that because I didn't have the appropriate utility module, I guess. Because sensor, levitate, grapple, or at least levitator and grapple, those sound like things that would move a box. Okay, so it wasn't a glitch. You are now granted unlimited access to all regions in Jingzhou. I have sent your terminal ID to every border pass and residence beacon. You will only need to display your terminal ID or activate a beacon with your... And again, this is going to be a cutoff piece of dialogue. Yes, yes it is. All right, another opportunity to move my VTuber model for a visual representation of where they messed up. All right. You are free to visit any part of Jingzhou, and that includes the city hall? Yes, including the city hall. You have full access to its facilities. Also, may I ask, have you decided your place of residence in Jingzhou? If not, Madam Magistrate has arranged accommodation for you in advance. Here in the city hall. Home sweet home. I will lead you to your room if you need. I have friends waiting outside. Excuse me, he said no pickles. Understood. We will be ready to accommodate you anytime. Black fruit, sugar, pearl, small device, leaf. Okay. When do I get to do summons? That's my question. Not yet, I guess. Okay. Fair. What the? Okay. Rover! It took you so long, what gives? Was our magistrate a chatterbox? You told Qixia and Yang Yang about your conversation with San Hua. So Madam Magistrate's not in the city hall. Why the long face? Ha ha ha, it sure is. It sure is. Okay. That's not, whatever. Chiksha. The increasing tacit fields, uncannily powerful tacit discords, and now our magistrate's absence, plus the mysterious rover. I'm afraid Jingzhu might be in danger? Well, we've reported to the city hall, the Ministry of War, and the academy. We've done everything we can do. I mean, this is Huanglong, and we're talking about Jingzhu of all places. We've been through our fair share of unrest over the past 1,000 years, and we've made it together every time. Are they talking about themselves, or are they talking about the city? Because that would be an interesting piece of lore if everyone was 1,000 years old or so. But I'm thinking they're talking about the city. There's been TD outbreaks every year, but we can always trust General Jian, Madam Magistrate, and our Sentinel to have our backs. We're not ones to mess with. United we stand, a bastion of might. One equals a legion, invulnerable in fight. Well said, Qixia. Do you have any plans, Rover? I don't think there's much for me to do. Rover, do you mind if we have a look at the tokens? You showed Yang Yang and Qixia the tokens. So what's so special about them? Take the candy. A candy? Oh. I've had these when I was a kid. I think they were called sugar pearls. But I haven't seen anything like this in a while. Went out of trend, maybe? It reminds me of my childhood. I still remember the taste. It was so sweet. I was really scared of getting my flu shots when I was little, and sometimes the nurse lady would hand out candies like this as a prize for being good. But what does it mean as a token? Take the small device. It seems like a miniature sundial. I believe so. On this sundial, there seems to be represented by the 12 earthly branches drawn on the outer ring of the surface. Oh, time seems to be represented. Sorry. Time seems to be represented by the 12 earthly branches drawn on the outer ring of its surface. And its inner ring shows the four symbols, each representing one cardinal direction. These are the four famous auspicious beasts in Huang Long's folklore. They are believed to protect people from all four... This is getting excruciating. Dialogue is cut off again. If I go to the next piece of dialogue, it will not give me the rest of what it's supposed to say here. It will start a different statement. So, I'm going to move my VTuber model again to indicate this is a place of interest or the notes. The bug notes. I need to report the bugs. There we go. Yeah. Okay. Generally, the teal long represents the east. The white tiger stands for the west. The vermilion bird stands for the south. And finally, we have the black tortoise for the north. It seems this sundial is supposed to show both time and direction, but how could it work when there is not a compass attached? Not to mention, the lack of sunlight basically renders it useless. Ugh. That requires way too much brain power. Take the leaf. The color of this leaf seems a bit odd. Can't tell what tree it is. I think I can feel something from it. Never mind. It's too faint. Maybe it was just my imagination. Sorry, I can't tell what kind of tree this leaf belongs to either. Take the black fruit. This is a mangosteen fruit. Mangosteens are not native to Jingzhou. They are usually imported by boat. I think we can find more mangosteens being sold at the nearby markets. It's not always available for purchase, though. The frequent tacit discord outbreaks can disrupt transportation and cause shortages. The Midnight Rangers have greatly improved the situation in recent years. Do nothing. So, Qingxi and I share similar childhood memories of the sugar pearl. Do you remember it too? Doesn't ring a bell. When it comes to candies, no one knows them better than the kids of Jingzhou. Let's go ask around. There's still some distance to the Huashu Academy. Let's see who reaches there faster. I installed some apps for you, remember? Just look for one that's called Utilities on the Terminal. Your terminal is installed with various utilities. Switch between tools to deal with various situations.
Oh! I'm falling!
I didn't think I had to push it again. Can I redo? Can I have a redo? I can't have a redo. No! Whoa. Oh, okay. That's pretty neat. There are quite a few tools to get around in this game, that's for sure. Oh, wait a sec. Someone's looking for me. Yeah, what? When did he disappear? Don't worry, it's all right. I'll be right there. Duty calls. Oops, almost forgot. Can't be late. Sorry, Rover, Yang Yang. I've got to head off for my shift. I'll join you right after I'm done, all right? If you need me, just shout my name. And I, Jinjo Speedster, will be there in a sec. For real? Well, you only need to send me a terminal message as you shout, and then I'll be there in a jiffy. Anyway, I've got to go. You guys okay on your own? Give me a heads up when there's any updates. Sure, do your thing. Don't worry, I'm staying with her. Rover, let's go inside. Lizzy hasn't replied to my message. She's probably busy in her lab. More Teffy. Anyway, let's try asking him, shall we? What, you need me for something? Oh, you need anything from me? We're here for Baizi. Mr. Mortify, please pardon our intrusion. We are friends of Baizi. We are here to look for her. I see. I hope I didn't cause any offense earlier. Not at all. It was us who bothered you. Baizi should be in the data analysis room. I'll go tell her you're here. Thank you, sir. Here you are. The data we collected in the Gorges of Spirits has been submitted for analysis. And we'll have the results today. I have the equipment for your physical examinations ready, too. Any discoveries during your trip to the City Hall? You showed Baizi the tokens you received and told her about what happened. What do you think, Baizi? I have a hypothesis about the Sugar Pearl. But I need to verify it first. If possible, I recommend conducting non-destructive tests of all these tokens you have. That sounds simple and clear. Data is always straightforward. The first three tokens can be tested at my branch's laboratory, branch of Remnant Studies. This miniature sundial will require radiographic testing, though. To access the necessary equipment, we'll need to file a request with one of the Tacitite. Tacitite, that's the field of Morteffi specializes in, isn't it? Yes, Morteffi is the branch of Tacitite Weaponry's head within the Department of Safety. One moment, please. Soon after, Baizi returned with Morteffi. Please give the items to be tested. Anything else you need me to know, you can let me know now. You may retrieve your items in 20 minutes, and the analysis report will be ready 5 minutes after that. Take a right. Dialogue's cut off again. A little bit of a visual note here. All right. Take out the sundial. Mortify took the sundial and gently weighed it in his hand. This one looks like the early handiwork of someone I know. It's lightweight and its design differs from that of the typical sundial, and it appears to be missing a part. See, there's a groove here. It will take some time before the results are ready. If you have other matters to take care of, you should go ahead. I'll let you know once we have the results. We'll take a quick look around here then. Sure you can, but don't forget your physical examination. I'll see you in a while for that.
Please do. Examine me right up.
I have the equipment ready. I'll need to check your health status and see if there are any unusual fluctuations. Now, let's begin if you're ready. Let's begin. Please take out your terminal, hold it tightly, and don't move. Press the button when the frequency signal reaches the designated area. For short signals, the button needs to be pressed briefly. For long signals, the button needs to be pressed long enough according to the signal length, then released. Ah, so we're playing OSU. Okay. Received successfully. As Yutan had previously detected, your bodily functions are in good condition, and you seem entirely unaffected by the crownless energy. What's strange is that there's not even the slightest excess fluctuation in your frequency energy. Can you try to manifest the crownless frequency without using your terminal? Sorry, it seems I can't do that. I'm not seeing the crownless data in your terminal, so it was indeed absorbed into your body. The crownless frequency energy was consumed by your body, leaving no trace behind. But how did you manage to do that? It's as though there's another mechanism within your body capable of absorbing frequency energy. What kind of impact will that have on me? I can't say without sufficient data. To put it simply, it seems there is another dimension or a creature hiding inside your body. Sounds like I have a little universe within me. A universe. That's a poetic and intriguing comparison. But judging from your physical condition, you're quite healthy and your various metrics are excellent. But if you feel anything unusual, please come find me anytime. Okay. New function unlocked. Convene! Let's go! Resonate with various resonators and weapons through Convene. It is an efficient way to meet reliable allies and collect powerful weapons. Okay, so I can summon on the banners now. Though I don't summon on husbandos, just as a general rule of thumb. So if you're expecting to see any of the husbandos, I'm sorry, you're out of luck. I only summon on waifus. I'll do this one. It looks like it's the beginner summon thing. Ooh! SSR first shot. Let's go. No, not a husbando. Might as well be a 3-star. Impossible. I got a purple weapon, it looks like. Okay. Do it again. Oh, it's just a purple. A bunch of husbandos! Ugh! I've been trampled on. The odds were not in my favor. Time to swallow sadness. No, I don't want to replace the red-headed waifu. I'm keeping the red-headed waifu. Thank you. Alright, I'll take a look at these. So the other SSR I got is this guy. He looks like Sephiroth. Final Fantasy VII. His name is Calcaro or Calcharo. And then I got Michael Jackson with blue hair. And I don't know. Ginjo from the Fullbring arc of Bleach, but with white hair. So Ginjo's hollow form. All right. Why did I not confirm that? Hold on. Oh, I did think. Oh, she's got guns. Let's go. Hold up. That's pretty sweet. Come on, come on, come on, yellow. Come on. Oh, purple. No. Ooh, hold up, though. Hold up. Hold up. Huh. Brr. Awooga! Those are some big ol' sweater puppies, that's for sure. Sheesh! I guess. Hello. So save up for the next 8 pull, and hopefully I get a waifu this time. I have been very disappointed so far. What does she use?
A great sword. Okay. And I have a purple great sword. I think we might need to be doing some testing in the lab, if you know what I mean. What? Oh, okay. So those are for dupes. What is this for? Oh, these are skill upgrades, I assume.
Take your time and enjoy the journey. Don't hurry too much, or you may miss out on all the beautiful sights along the way. You don't want to reach the end of the road with nothing to show for it. Just some tips from someone who's been there before.
As someone who does voice work professionally, but albeit for a radio station, still, they really did go all out. I mean, oh, I listened to this voice actor, actress. That's a... they probably paid someone $5 at least. Either that or used an AI voice model. That's pretty possible. I also use AI frequently for things like my AI cover songs, so I understand why someone might want to use an AI voice model instead. Pose. Oh my. Those things could start a thermonuclear apocalypse if she's not careful. Those are WMDs, that's for sure. Sheesh! Okay. I need to get some experience upgrade stuff before I use anyone else. Ooh, hold up. Okay. Backpack. Pretty typical for games like this to have little achievements to give you like 5 to 10 currencies for summoning each. Oh, hold up. Okay. I guess we just continue on. Here's your sundial, intact as it was. Mr. Mortify, can we have the test results? Simply put, it's hollow. Here, try tapping on it. It sounds different from a solid object. It's not just a timekeeping tool. It's an intricate mortise and tenon puzzle box. The sundial is hollow with an inner compartment. We've scanned it, and there is a small paper scroll inside. However, it's missing a crucial component. We should be able to spin the wheels on the sundial once the right component is installed. You're quite the expert. I have some basic knowledge, but there is someone else who is more knowledgeable in automata mechanics than I am. It wouldn't have taken me this long if we were dealing with tacitite weapons. Install the missing part, then rotate the wheels to their correct positions, and you should be able to solve the puzzle and access the paper scroll. However, I still have no idea what the missing component should look like. Maybe we can brute force it. Well, that's indeed a no-brainer. We can certainly give it a try if you're fine with the paper scroll being destroyed by its protective mechanism, that is. One moment, I have an incoming call. What's going on? You certainly are well informed. It's indeed beautiful data. Good taste. Well, since you've put it that way. Moreover, Mr. Mortifee's expression seems to have softened, don't you think? Yeah, he looks like a purring cat now. We haven't even asked him to help us with assembling. He's already starting to work on it. Looks like Mr. Mortifee needs some more time. Maybe we should give him some space to concentrate. Rover, let's come back later, shall we? Oh. Yes, of course. I've already noticed all that you mentioned. Indeed, you just pointed out a blind spot in my thinking. Your workshop? That hellish place? Yeah, stop sweet-talking me. I get it. Sorry for keeping you waiting. Let's get back to the sundial. It is a mortise and tenon-based puzzle box. The missing component in the middle needs to fulfill two entirely different structural requirements at the same time. Considering its entire structure, this component needs an automatic buckle that goes down on top of an embedded pointer. I'll draw up a design for you. The parts you'll need can be found in Zheng Li's workshop. I've already informed him about it. You'll only need to go fetch the parts in his place. He keeps a box full of them. Okay. Let's get it over with. Madame, give me a dialogue thing for that one. Hold on. Okay, we're good. I mentally prepared myself for the worst, but this place looks much better than Mr. Mortifee's description, I think. Though it is a bit hard to figure out where we should start. The unusual device has complex structure and a groove that can fit an entire arm. I don't think that that's what we're looking for. Oh, right here. You saw a shelf filled with an assortment of research material and books, a feasibility report on cooking tacit discords, jiting mysteries, mortise and tenon joints in Huanglong architecture, also resting on, and that is another area where the dialogue just cuts off. So, jiggle my model here so that I have a bit of a visual indicator. All right. Now I can get back to it. The shelf creaked under your hand. You tried to steady it, but it was too late. A wooden block fell squarely onto your foot. You took a critical hit. Rover, you took a critical hit. This should be it. It's quite a box full. Let's go back and show it to Mr. Mortifee. Mr. Mortifee, we found the parts. Good, bring it to me. The test results are in. I'm all ears. The mangosteen is just an ordinary fruit. It's suitable for regular consumption. We found nothing unusual about it. From the purple leaf you presented, I detected subtle fluctuations in tacit discords frequency from two distinct sources, but they were overlapping and difficult to distinguish. This is a rare occurrence.
The scattered nature of these fluctuations rules out the possibility of them being left behind through contact. This is not an ordinary leaf, but it doesn't seem to be a tacit discord either. Based on the data we gathered, I believe it was sampled from an area struck with the wave-worn phenomenon. Wave-worn phenomenon? Yes, the anomalies that occurred after the lament, including the formation of tacit fields, etheric sea, retroact rain, and gravity loss. These are collectively called wave-worn phenomenon. And the lament was the start of it all. As for the sugar pearl, it has been determined to be a type of oral vaccine. The sugar pearl expired over 20 years ago. The low temperature storage life for this vaccine is about 2 years. A 20-year-old vaccine. Is it about the children's epidemic in Jingzhou 2 decades ago? The archives in the academy should have information on the sugar pearl. The archives here are organized in a unique way. You can start by searching the keywords at the lobby terminal. Mr. Mortify, the missing pointer has been installed, and now the sundial should be complete. So the discs are rotatable now. Correct. Align the correct markers with the pointer that we just installed, and then you should be able to open it. The earthly branches represent time, and 4 symbols. These symbols are related to sexagenary cycle. It's an intricate way of recording time in Henglong. Nowadays, it is mainly reserved for calendars, numerology, and indexing, but it's fallen out of use lately. Now, what kind of information could it represent? It's the filing system. Most of Huanglong's library and databases still use this method to organize their archives, namely the grand libraries. Oh, I already read that. Baizi just mentioned, the Academy's public archives are organized in this manner too. Let's go find the archives about the sugar pearl. That's great and all, but I kind of want to go back and like fight stuff again. Is that a possibility, or am I stuck here? Am I a hostage? I'm not. Let's go. We can get out of here. We could come back and do some more story some other time, but I want to go and fight some stuff again. Hold up. I just got a message on Discord. What? Come on. There we go. My best friend sent me some schizo stuff. It's not that big of a deal. All right. I'll check it out later. But I'm pretty sure it's schizo stuff. Let's go fight some stuff. Let's go beat them up. Let's go do some hell sweeps on some enemies. Let's do some low parries and some grabs. Kind of want to play Tekken now. Ooh, need to activate this. I don't even care. Don't I have a map? I could just like teleport back to the areas I've been to. I guess not. Oh. I thought I activated a few of these things already. That's crazy. All right, well, whatever. We'll just walk. I kind of want to use it. Yeah. Aha. Yeah, that's right. I knew it. Ooh, what's that up there? Whoa, okay, that was cool. Hold on, I need to do that again. Okay. Oh, I guess it doesn't work perfectly every time, huh? There we go. That's pretty cool. That might be something I need to mention in the potential bug report notes for the developers. But I won't worry about that too much. Enemies. Okay, those aren't enemies. Never mind. Enemies. Oh, okay. Immune? Fusion prisms. Okay, that's not working. Oh, yeah. I'll have to read those tutorials later. Yeah, this game has a really good combat system. I can't say that enough. Very fluid. Lots of little different intricate tools within the combat system. Oh, there's a chest right there. There's a beacon right there. Let's take a look around for a moment. What's in that? Get the cow meat. Enter the forgery challenge. Oh, I'm not high enough level. Okay. Very cool. What the heck? These guys are attacking each other? Okay, I like this character a lot. I like this character a lot. Very fun. Okay. All right. I want to see what her ultimate does. Okay, that's pretty cool. I really don't feel like this charge shot does a whole lot, though. Basically does the same amount of damage that the rapid fire shots do, so I don't know what the point is. Title Heritage.
Yeah. Take this.
What the? Why is my camera resetting? Oh, is it because of this? There's something over here. Yeah, so I guess the NPCs fight against themselves. This is so cool. Whew. Excuse me. Oh, well, that one did more damage. Maybe it's for shooting like other fauna. Like, maybe it's not necessarily for shooting monsters. Maybe it's for like hunting meat, and that's specifically what this charge shot's for. I don't know. Let me see how much this does. Come on, shoot the thing regularly. It does 19 per little pew pew. So, I mean, that's not that far off from 31, to be honest. It's just the animal fauna is really, really weak, just like in all other games like Genshin and whatever. So they don't really have any resistances. Flame on, she says. I also say that. Especially when I was in gym class during physical day. I said flame on quite often. All the way back in high school.
Ooh, what's this? Big boy? Hello? Oh, it's level 30. Get me out. Get me out. Get me out. Did it stop following me? It stopped following me. Okay, we're good. What is this? Okay. Okay. Well, it's only level 10. I thought it was an enemy, but I wasn't sure. Ow. Maybe the charge shot does more damage the more her meter is charged. Ow. A flame on. Yeah, this is actually the best character. This is my main right here. This is my waifu. Don't at me. Ow. Okay. Thrown to a distance to cause an explosion through levitator. Okay. As it turns out, you're not supposed to go up and punch an explosive vine thing. Makes sense. Ow. That sound actually was supposed to be for a counterattack. And I was supposed to dodge that. I think I have enough materials to upgrade the Big Booba Mommy. Pink haired Big Booba Mommy. No, I don't. Unfortunate. What time is it? Oh, it's midnight. I've been streaming for what, like 4 hours now? 3 hours? All right, chat. Here's the deal. I have to work tomorrow, and I'm also tired. But I also want to go spend time with my friends. And unfortunately, I can't trust some of them not to get me banned. So, I'd like to go say hi to them right now. And that means I'd like to end the stream. To everyone who is watching currently or maybe watching in the future through a VOD, thank you for watching. And please, if you like my content, you like my style, go ahead and subscribe. And I don't, this is kind of a new thing that I've been doing. You know, I don't normally stream often, but I will be streaming a lot more now that I found this free VTuber model. Especially since
have this closed beta test. I will be streaming a lot more of this on my days off, which my day off this week starts Thursday. So expect longer streams on my days off. I want to thank you for watching and supporting my channel. Have a great night and God bless.